Hey, hello everyone. My name is Bradley Sinopoli, and I would like to welcome you to the recording of the Grand Prix Trial San Jose semifinals hosted by the lovely people at Jacks on Queen. After five rounds of intense Swiss play, there's a ruthless cut to top four, and the match I have for you today is the semifinals of that top four. On the left, we have Frédéric Gagnon playing Merfolk versus Michael Lewis on the right playing Grixis Delver. So without further ado, let's get this show on the road. Okay, so what I've done is I've sped up the tape to two times its normal speed, so we're going to be seeing modern magic in super fast time. To start with, it looks like Fred is going to keep his opening hand of seven, while Mike is mulliganing to six. I've played against Merfolk enough to know that being behind is generally not a place you want to be. I mean, I know Grixis Delver can get out of the gates pretty quick, but alright, so it looks like Mike kept resolving his scry and is putting it to the bottom. Fred's starting out with an Island Curse Catcher. So Curse Catcher is a 1-1 for one blue, and you can sacrifice it to counter a an instant or sorcery. You can sacrifice it to counter an instant or sorcery. Michael plays a Shockland. Fred goes to combat, but before combat, Mike bolts the Curse Catcher. Second main phase, Fred plays a Silvergill Adept, which is a 2-mana 2-1. When it enters the battlefield, you can reveal a Merfolk from your hand. And if you draw a card, and it looks like Fred revealed a Master of Waves. Mike here fetching a watery grave with his Flooded Strand, and drops what appears to be a Delver of Secrets. So for those of you that don't know, Delver Secrets is a 1-mana 1-1 where Spreading Seas. Spreading Seas is a 2-mana enchantment that turns a land into an island, and when it enters the battlefield, the caster of Spreading Seas gets to draw a card. And in response to the Spreading Seas, Mike decided to bolt the Silvergill Adept. So right, back to Delver. You can reveal a card. You reveal the first card you draw each turn, and if it's an instant or sorcery, it flips into a 3-2 flyer. Looks like Mike got his other non-basic land hit with another Spreading Seas, and Fred decided to Aether Vial as well. Mike revealed a instant, so he got to flip his Delver. Fred ticks up the Aether Vial. That is two Mutavolts on the field. Two or three? Looks like three Mutavolts on the field for Mr. Fred. That appears to be a Lord of Atlantis for Mr. Gagnon. And animating that Mutavolt to get in for 3 damage as Lord of Atlantis is a +1/+1 to other merfolk, and since Mutavolt is all creatures, yeah, it works. That's the third bolt from Mr. Lewis to take care of the Lord of Atlantis. That's a Snapcaster, the other creature that Mike Lewis has. Fred attempts to resolve a Master of Waves. Master of Waves is a 4-drop. sorry, 4-drop Merfolk. Protection from red, it's a 2-1. Elemental creatures you control get +1/+1. And why that's relevant is because when it enters the battlefield, you get 1/0 elementals for your devotion to blue. And thanks to Spreading Seas on Michael's lands, he gets three. Looks like from Michael it was a draw swing pass. Oh, and another fun interaction with Mutavault is that it also counts as an elemental, so Master of Waves pumps elementals as well. Pumps Mutavaults, sorry. That's a neat little interaction. If you have Lords and Master of Waves out. And that looks like a scoop from Mike Lewis. Alright. So we have Fred on Merfolk taking game one. Oh. You don't want to be shuffling your opponent's Spreading Seas into your library. That's definitely counterproductive to your deck, anyways. So, looking at these gentlemen's sideboards as I have the list in front of me, maybe. I'm currently looking at Fred's list. I think Unified Will would be a decent counterspell to bring in, as well as probably Spellskite to kind of eat up some of those lightning bolts that Mike throws out. And in terms of Mike's sideboard, looks like he has one copy of Anger of the Gods. Does he have any of those in? He has none of those in the main board, so it's just the one in the sideboard. So probably bringing in that Anger of the Gods, bringing in the Electrolyze. Is it Staticaster? Maybe. For the Elementals. Because pinging all the Elementals with a single, is it Staticaster, is pretty good. Rakdos Charm might be a fun little slapback. That's once again in the Grixis Delver sideboard for matches like Merfolk or Elves, where your opponent floods the board, or even Kikikord. Your opponent decides to make 12,000 Restoration Angels, and you just say, "Okay, Rakdos Charm." They'll deal one to you. You're at negative 11,000 life. Alright, so let's see how our players decide to mulligan here. Michael chooses who will be on the play this round. And he starts off with a Island Delver. That's the start you want. Oh. That appears to be a Cavern of Souls. And another Delver for Mike Lewis. Fred is sitting on an Aether Vial. There appears to be a Mutavault. And a Silvergill Adept revealing Silvergill Adept. Oh, that's gonna be fun. You can see Michael checking for the Delver trigger. Ooh, Fork Bolt? Fork Bolt dealing one to the Adept and one to Fred's face. Getting really aggressive here from Mike Lewis. Jamming in with the team. Looks like another Cavern of Souls. Yep, another Cavern of Souls. I'm assuming it's naming Merfolk. Otherwise, that would be pretty silly. Slamming another Silvergill Adept, revealing a Lord of Atlantis to draw a card. Nope, no instant sorcery for the Delver trigger. Mike appears to be stuck on two lands, as he could have played a third turn last turn, or a third land last turn. Another Delver. Oh my. End of Mike's turn, activating Aether Vault or Aether Vial to flash in Lord of Atlantis. Seems good. A fourth land for Mr. Fred. He has not missed a single land drop. While Mr. Lewis is stuck on two. Flashing in Reejiri. Mero Reejiri. It is a Merfolk Lord, and whenever you play a Merfolk spell, you may tap or untap target permanent. Curse Catcher, which is now 1 mana 2/2, 1 mana 3/3, sorry, thanks to the Lord of Atlantis and Reejiri. Fred's board just kind of exploded. Using the mana, or using the untap ability from Mero Reejiri to untap the land. To play a Lord of Atlantis. Or Master of Waves. Oh my goodness. So what is that? What's his devotion? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That is a lot. 6 or 7? 6. 6 Merfolk. Elementals. I cannot talk. Oh my goodness. Six elementals. All right, jamming time. Thanks to Mero Reejiri, all Merfolk. Nope, it's the Lord of Atlantis. Yes, Lord of Atlantis gives all Merfolk Island Walk. And thanks to Mr. Lewis's one island in play, I think that was the game. Wow. That was revealing Spell Snare and flipping all the Delvers and dealing 9. We're going to game 3. See, that's the threat of Delver, though. It's a 1 mana 1/1, but if you're not careful, then can get quite unruly quite quick. Star City Games did a one of their famous animal prints, Delver of Squeakwits. It's a little mouse. It's kind of adorable. I love all of their animal art. Deathrite Salmon's probably my favorite. All right, going to game 3, Merfolk versus Grixis Delver. It's on. Fred is deciding. I'm assuming he's going to be on the play. This does not look good for Mike Lewis. He mulliganed game one. Ran out of gas kind of quick. Even on the draw, it's eh. You get the scry and then the draw, but against a deck that can easily race you, you do not want to be behind. Mr. Lewis resolving his scry on the bottom. Alright. Fred starting with Curse Catcher. Very nice. Untapped Watery Grave to start. Oh, sorry. That was a Polluted Delta. The fetch. Grabbing a Steam Vents, having it come in untapped. Or nope, maybe not. It was untapped. Untap, upkeep, draw for turn. Another Polluted Delta, bringing himself to 17 after the one damage from Curse Catcher. Notably, no two drop from the Merfolk. There's Young Pyromancer. Ooh. A dismember? That's a lot of damage to take care of a young pyromancer. But hey, whatever works. Might as well get rid of it now. Tapping three for Kira, the great glass spinner. She's a 3-drop 2/2 flyer. Creatures you control have, whenever this creature becomes the target of a spell or ability for the first time each turn, counter it. That's pretty big. That's real big. Third land for Mike Lewis. Thought Scour. Milling two, drawing a card. Trying to fill up that yard as best he can for the one mana Tassigar or Grim Egg Angler. Those do work against Merfolk. Unless they have Island Walk. Thought Scouring himself again. And passing the turn. There's another Mutavault to animate the Mutavault. Swinging in what appears to be 5. Yep, no other effects. Passing back to Mike. Cracking a fetch. Bloodstained Mire going for a basic mountain. And passing back. Oh boy. Oh boy, this ain't good. Fred animates the Mutavault with Mutavault. Gets in for 5. Looks like there's a response here. Flashing in Snapcaster Mage. Targeting Thought Scour. Yep, Thought Scour is exiled. Blocking the Mutavault. Okay. Still taking 3. Looks like he's down to 7. Unless my eyes deceive me, which they sometimes do. Fetching again. How much damage has Mike done to himself? I think he's cracked 5 fetches so far. Against Merfolk. Your life is a pretty important resource. What is that? Was that the Gurmag Angler? That looks like Gurmag Angler. There it is. That's a big fishy. Now, Kira does have flying. So it can get over Gurmag Angler. So we'll have to see what happens. Kira is giving all of Fred's creatures the pseudo hexproof ability. It's getting in with Kira. Having 2 for a Silvergill, revealing a Master of the Pearl Trident. Electrolyze. Was that 2 to the dome? Ooh. That was rude. Spell Pierce. Spell Pierce to stop the Electrolyze. Deciding what he wants to do with. What is that? A Spire Bluff Canal. Fork Bolt again. Targeting Kira. Gets countered. Oh, the second Spell Pierce? Oh my. Oh, and then he paid for it, but he sacrificed the Curse Catcher. Oh, dude, what? That was rude. And that's game. Wow. That was crazy. The double Spell Pierce in hand. He paid for it, and then he sacrificed the Curse Catcher for one more. That's all she wrote. Looks like Mr. Fred is headed off to the finals.